like to welcome you once more to the Radoga cluster on the edge of the wonderful city of Krasnoyarsk in Siberia as we get racing underway once more in cross-country skiing. Here is the hard work going on in the waxing room as the technicians apply what they hope is the right combination. The dark science of waxing skis. And it makes a huge difference, let me tell you, as to how well you go around the course, the temperature of the snow, its composition, its how firm or soft it might be. And these athletes are depending on their technicians to get them across the line. Ivan Kirillov, bronze medalist from yesterday's racing. Anton Timoshov, he was silver medalist in the 10K Classic. And the gold went to Ivan Yakimishkin. And he will start first, according to those results from yesterday, in today's 10-kilometre pursuit final. And the air temperature, very pleasant, minus one. And there is no wind to speak of. It's cloudy. Thought the clouds might have moved away as they did yesterday, but it's remained a little overcast. No sign of any snow, though. And here is the field. It's a big field, 86 athletes from 25 nations. And the margin on the right-hand side of your screens there is how far behind the first skier they will start. And those margins dictated by their results from yesterday. Having said that, though, the last 14 skiers will all go at 5 minutes, just to compress the timing of the race a little. But a great field. So everybody bar one, it would seem, backing up from yesterday's first race. We had 87 yesterday, although there was also a did not start, and an 86 today. So big strong field, but particularly so for the Russian Federation, who filled the first six places yesterday. Yakimushkin then has a 15 second margin over Timoshov at the start, and Kirillov a further 3 seconds behind. So the real question mark over the start of this race is, will Yakimushkin allow Timoshov and Kirillov to catch him and make it a race in three and then sort it out at the end as the women did? Or will he utilize that 15-second advantage to try and push away and ski the race effectively on his own? Either scenario, it really looks like Russia 1-2-3 again. They are the top six. The next fastest non-Russian is a minute and six behind Yakimushkin, and that's Louis Schwartz. Away we go. And it is the men's 10K pursuit, and it is Ivan Yakimushkin who leads them away. And what will be his thought process? What is his race strategy? It's all worked out. Perhaps it's for the team, perhaps it's for himself, but it will be a Russian Federation race one feels as we begin with Ivan Kirillov and Timoshov. Timoshov there on screen in bib number two. And it was a further 3 seconds back to Kirillov. And Poroshkin is 29 seconds behind Yakimushkin. From Smolensk is Poroshkin. And Subakarev, 51 seconds behind, and then at 56 seconds is Kilivniuk. And then we wait 10 seconds for the first of the skiers not from the Russian Federation. It is Louis Schwartz in bib number seven. In eight is Ivan Luft, who was 22nd in this event 2 years ago, so it's a second Universiade for Luft. Bib 12 there, Sarkinen. And here is the race between Timoshov and Kirillov. So we'll wait for the 1.1 kilometre checkpoint to see whether they've taken anything out of Yekomushkin's 15-second lead, which was his margin at the start. That'll give us an indication. Yekomushkin skied a very interesting race yesterday in the Classic, because he did not start quickly, and it didn't look like he could win it. Sobakarev was the quickest of the starters over the first few kilometres, but Yekomushkin knew exactly what he was doing as he ran them all down with a great race time of 21 minutes. I beg your pardon, yesterday his winning time was not 21 minutes. We'll just get to that in a moment to see this margin. And Timoshov 18 seconds. So Yekomushkin has actually pushed it out another 4 seconds. Timoshov and Kirillov, less than a second between them. And fourth through, Poroshkin 38 seconds. Poroshkin was 29 seconds behind at the start. So Yekomushkin is skiing a different sort of race today. And early indications are he's just going to try and keep his pursuers at bay. So it's shaping up a little differently to the women's race. 18.8 seconds. Through comes Schwartz, Luft, a minute and eight behind. He was a minute 10 behind at the start. So Luft has skied a pretty quick opening 1,100 metres. Schwartz, 108, and he was 106 behind at the start. So pretty even going for him. And in 11, it's Paul Combet. France, 1:38 behind now, so he's dropped 6 seconds on Yekomushkin's time. And through they come in pretty good numbers now. And just a little look over his right shoulder to see who is coming and how far back from Yekomushkin. The excitement, the joy of actually winning does take something out of the mind and body, and how quickly can you recover within 24 hours? It's not just the physical effort, but the gold medal placed around his neck by President Putin must have surely been the highlight of his competitive life. And how could he have slept last night? Well, he's going okay. His lead was 15 seconds, and now it's 22 from Timoshov and Kirillov. He's certainly taken it out hard, Ivan Yekomushkin. So still Russia 1, 2, 3, 4. Poroshkin 39 down, and he was 29 at the start, so well, Yekomushkin is really opening up this gap. Sobakarev and Livniuk 58 seconds down. So Sobakarev has lost a few seconds in that next 800 metres. In 7 is Louis Schwartz, and 8, Ivan Luft. I mentioned they both skied 2 years ago and finished 13th and 22nd in this corresponding race in Almaty. Timoshov and Kirillov can try to work together to make some kind of run at Yekomushkin, but it doesn't look like they're able to. It's the 22-year-old Ivan Yekomushkin. All right, we're at the 6.1-kilometre checkpoint. Just under 4Ks to go for Yekomushkin. And here they come, Timoshov and Kirillov. Is the margin around 25 or closer to 30? just watch this clock, see where it stops for Timoshov, who's in two. Kirillov in three. And 26 seconds, and Yakimushkin isn't giving them much. It's been as much as 28 and a half seconds, and just taking out 1 or 2 seconds every checkpoint, it's not really going to do it. Yakimushkin has it at the moment. 6 and 5 there are Kilivniuk and Subakarev. It will be the aim of the Russians to fill the top six places again, as they did yesterday in the Classic. So Subakarev is as one of the stronger teams here. They can enter a maximum of 6 competitors, the Russian Federation, and bring a team of 8 if they choose to, and enter 6. Still these two going together. Louis Schwartz in 7 for France, and Ivan Liuft of Kazakhstan in bib number 8. So what is the margin between Subakarov, say, who's a minute and 2 behind Yakimushkin, and these next two, Schwartz and Liuft? So there are a further 49 seconds, 1:52 almost behind Yakimushkin. So we won't be seeing them on the podium. It's going to be Russia. A clash of skis there, and nearly coming to grief was number 12, Jonas Sakinen of Finland. Someone's ski ran across the front of his, as Yakimushkin now comes through at 6.9 in 16.01. Now the others are in view. They're not skiing particularly quickly because there's an incline, of course, up to this checkpoint. But let's see whether Timoshov has made a bit of an effort here. Well, still well over 20 seconds. But 23, all right, they've taken a few seconds out of the lead of Yakimushkin, but they're running out of kilometres to pass him or get him in sight so that they can really do something. They can see him from time to time, but Poroshkin comes through. He's 39 down. Poroshkin. He's 15 seconds out of a medal place. Yakimushkin comes into the stadium again. He'll have one more lap to do. Each of these laps 2.5 Ks, 2 on the red, 2 on the blue. Three races so far. 9 medals, all to the Russian Federation here at the Radiga Cluster for the cross country. Timoshov and Kirillov. Can focus, if nothing else, on the race for second and third. These two can't be separated. They're acting as a buffer between Yakimushkin and any challenges from behind. Yakimushkin, even if he's lost a couple of seconds out of that lead, it looks unlikely he'll be deprived of a second gold medal in 24 hours. As 5 and 6 come through, Subakarev and Kilivniuk, Russia 1-6. Familiar looking scoreboard in the men's cross country. A couple of years ago, in 2017 at the Universiade, Dmitry Rostovtsev won the gold, silver to Veleni Gontar. Quite a healthy margin for Rostovtsev that day. It was nearly 15 seconds. It's more than that, though, for Yakimushkin over Timoshov and Kirillov. Still sitting second and third. It's stride for stride they go. They can see their man, Yaki Mushkin. But a sizable climb between him and them. Yaki Mushkin is doing enough. Coming up to 20 minutes race duration. The women in the freestyle event to skied about 2 minutes quicker than in the classic yesterday. Poroshkin. These last climbs really do hurt and test the athletes. He's 23 years of old, Ilya Poroshkin. Kolivniuk on the right, on the left in five, Andrei Sobakarev. Kolivniuk, the youngest of the top six, at 20 years of age. Really got to build the miles into the legs to find the endurance you need. Still together, 7 and 8, Schwartz and Luft of France and Kazakhstan, respectively. In 9, it's Aset Yusinov. And Yunus Sakinen has raced a pretty good opening 7Ks. Moving up a few positions. So only a couple of Ks left for our leaders. As the chasers make their way up this cruel incline. You have to go up to go down. And the wind through the hair of Yaki Mushkin as he goes around that fast right-hand bend. Safely negotiated. A bit of a hop, step and a jump as he gets back into full rhythm. And just 800 metres to go now as he comes through the 9.2 checkpoint. Running out of time and distance, Timoshov and Kirillov to have any chance of catching him. Certainly doing their best. They're really lifting here with Timoshov and Kirillov, or is Timoshov just trying to shake off Ivan Kirillov as they come through? And they're still 22, 23 seconds behind. The tempo lifting between these two. Well, they can sense the finish line. 800 metres away. Through comes Poroshkin. He's given up any chance of finishing on the podium. He's 26 seconds behind the man in third, Kirillov. And almost 50 behind Yaki Mushkin. He'll try and finish as strongly as he possibly can. And Sobakarev and Kolivniuk also chasing hard. Let's hope we'll come across to the stadium now. We do, because I could see that Yaki Mushkin was coming in and he's only negotiating this last turn and into the home straight, and it's going to be a very comfortable and proud stride to the line for Ivan Yaki Mushkin as he picks up a second gold medal in as many days. Thanks the crowd. And eases across the line in 23 minutes, 3.5 seconds. Gold to the Russian Federation, and the race for silver and bronze. Oh, they stretch out the skis, and it looks like Timoshov has got it over Kirillov, but they're going to go to the photo. Oh, they really tested each other there. And Timoshov just could not get rid of Ivan Kirillov, who stuck with him like glue in the last few hundred metres as he lifted the pace. Who's got it? Well, it certainly looks like Timoshov on this near side. But they do like to check with a photo, and that's understandable. should be able to confirm that for you in a minute. As Poroshkin comes across the line. Ivan Yakimushkin, though, makes it his from Anton Timoshov and Ivan Kirillov. First, second and third in the men's 10K pursuit. Cloud a little thicker than earlier in the day. Might get some snow. Got a great race, just finished. Days of racing at the cross country, at the Ruttiger cluster, four events and 12 medals going to the Russian Federation. They have been dominant. Now let's see the next three awarded for the men's 10K pursuit.
Third place and bronze medalists representing the Russian Federation, Ivan Kirillov.
Ivan Kirillov from Moscow University. Really threw down a fine challenge to Timoshov to try and take the silver medal away from him, and was just centimetres short of achieving that. Great race skied by him, and a second bronze medal in as many days for Kirillov.
Second place and silver medalist representing the Russian Federation, Anton Timoshov.
Timoshov. As with Kirillov, a second medal in as many days and the same colour as in the classic race. And he gets the silver, but only just.
The winner of the 29th Winter Universiade Krasnoyarsk 2019, representing the Russian Federation, Ivan Yakimushkin.
Ivan Yakimushkin started with an advantage of 15 seconds. He pushed that out to nearly 30 at various stages. Knew he had the race won in the closing few hundred metres and just eased down to win it by 15.7 seconds. A couple of minutes slower than the classic time. That's quicker, I beg your pardon, than the classic time. Three, in fact, that's expected. Freestyle technique that much quicker than the classic. Well, it's been a quite joyful experience on this second day of cross-country competition, particularly in terms of success for the Russian Federation, but for all athletes taking part in front of a very appreciative, fun-loving crowd at a wonderful facility. Hope you've enjoyed it so far, and there'll be more great cross-country racing to come from Ruttiger in the Universiade of Krasnoyarsk 2019. Hope to see you again soon.